Whether you believe in them or not, demonic possessions can be classified as a strange phenomenon that has occurred in practically every culture for thousands of years. Modern technology now allows the world to document these supposed possessions in a way that history has never let us before. Take a look at these potential cases of demonic possession and let me know if you think evil spirits can take control of our own bodies against our will. Number 10. Rural possession. This footage is supposedly from the 70s and is said to have been recovered from someone's attic in Iowa, IOWA. You're about to see some shocking clips from this film, but the full version is so violent and disturbing that I can't show everything. Anyway, the video begins with someone walking up to a possessed person lying in bed. This person is very gaunt and still, breathing heavily, staring straight ahead. Suddenly a nearby door opens all by itself. We can't show you this next part, but the person appears to be ripping their fingernails off one by one while they are hunched over. I don't mean just a hangnail, either, I mean the entire nail. The man looks up at the camera and the scene abruptly ends. Apparently being in pain must make this thing very happy, because in the next scene it's sitting upright in bed, smiling and laughing demonically. The bedridden figure suddenly thrashes around wildly while screaming, and then you won't believe what it does next. It slices away at its lips and neck with a razor blade until it is completely bloodied and disfigured. This scene makes up a large part of the video, but unfortunately I can't show it here. At one point the possessed man cuts off his lips and is staring straight at the camera, his teeth jagged and bloody. The final scene is him slicing away at its throat. It looks like there is no way he could have made it. I really hope this is all makeup and special effects. If so, it's very convincing and well done. Number 9. Sleep haunting. A YouTuber named Dale Pendlebury, Doyle, Pendlebury, is getting terrible sleep and wants to know what is going wrong. It isn't necessarily a lack of sleep that's the problem, he thinks, but rather the quality. Even though he makes sure to get between 7 to 8 hours of sleep every night, he still always wakes up in the morning feeling like he had gotten no sleep at all. He needs to get to the bottom of this, so he sets up a camcorder to record himself overnight in bed. Little did he know that what he was recording was his own possession. His camera only films when it detects motion or audio, which spares Dale the trouble of fast-forwarding through the slow parts. When he reviews the tape, everything starts out looking ordinary, but soon after the first night, things start to get very strange. By night 3, something is apparently throwing him around in his own bed. More strange noises happen throughout the next night, and at one point he even sits straight up and looks straight at the camera. There is no expression on his face at all, but it looks like his eyes are completely open. Dale drops back hard onto his bed without a word. Then, on the final night, Dale does this. It's hard to tell if this is real or fake for sure. Most of the comments on his video say that this is definitely real, so maybe that will help you decide. Number 8. TJ's goes insane. A YouTuber named Adam Park and his friends are pulling an all-nighter with Call of Duty when they get interrupted by some loud noises at 3 in the morning. The only other person in the house besides them is Adam's roommate, TJ, and the noises are coming from his room.
Okay. What the fuck?
Fuck is that?
Oh my god, what the fuck?
Yo,
go!
Adam knows that something weird is going on, so he pulls out his phone and starts recording.
What the fuck, dude? Should we call the cops?
Yo, call the cops.
Call the cops, bro.
Oh my god.
Alright, let's go. Let's
TJ.
Go.
Yo,
dude, go in there.
We gotta help him. Bro.
TJ!
We gotta help him, bro.
Adam opens the door and peeks down the hall. This is what he hears. The noise sends all four friends running back into Adam's room. One of them calls the police and the rest decide to do what they can to help their friend.
Yo.
What Yo, the get fuck? The fuck out of here, call
DJ,
call.
Are you okay, dude?
When they bravely walk back into the hallway, however, they find that TJ is far beyond help. Out of all of the videos on this list, I'd have to say that this one looks the easiest to fake. It wouldn't be that hard to have your friend run all around the house and then edit in some scary sound effects to make it seem like a possession. Then again, everyone does seem pretty scared in this video. Usually at least one person is a bad actor and easy to spot in fake videos, but these guys all seem pretty convincing. The way they keep switching from being scared to nervous seems realistic. If it is real, then I have no idea what happened after they stopped recording. Number 7. Brandon vs. Zozo. Cole and Ethan go to the mall and buy a Ouija board so they can, in their words, put down a camera and see what happens. They buy the board and go back their friend Brandon's home to set things up. It soon becomes obvious that they are not taking the idea of a Ouija board seriously at all. The whole time they constantly make jokes about becoming possessed. This negative attitude could be why things go wrong so quickly. Even when it's time to try and summon ghosts, they continue to treat the situation with blatant disrespect. Nothing happens for a while, so they take a break and then come back to it later.
Can anybody hear us? My hand is getting tired.
Okay, if anybody can hear us, move the thing, because move it.
Can't just be so mean.
This time they take the Ouija board a little more seriously and try to concentrate a little harder. Before they know it, the pointer is actually moving by itself. Cole and Ethan both swear that they aren't intentionally pushing it. They ask for the spirit's name and the pointer lands on the number 6 in response. But when the spirit says that this is not its real name, they repeat the question again. Instead of saying its name, the pointer moves over to a picture of the moon and then stops. This is supposed to symbolize darkness, which means that this spirit is probably evil. At this point, Cole no longer doubts the power of the Ouija board and decides to call things off. He is too scared to continue at first, but they think about it for a while and then come to the conclusion that they have to finish what they've already started. The friends all sit down around the Ouija board and start filming again. They ask what the spirit wants, and this is the response.
Have you ever seen that?
No, dude.
Are you kidding me?
Right,
did it just
move? It definitely just moved by itself.
Okay, are you kidding? Oh my gosh.
The spirit spells out the word, peace, and then highlights the word, no. No peace. Then it highlights the word, goodbye, followed by the word, no. No goodbye. In other words, it's saying that it's not leaving. No peace. No goodbyes. It's here to stay. By now everyone is too scared to continue, but by now they also don't have a choice. Brandon is acting very strange at this point. He starts to move the pointer all over the board while grinning to himself. Then he starts laughing. None of his friends can even recognize him at this point.
Okay, that... hey, that's...
Still not funny after these...
He's never looked or acted this way before. According to them, Brandon became temporarily possessed that night and started lashing out at them. They managed to get him under control, but he has been depressed and not exactly himself after this experience ever since. As many YouTubers have pointed out, the friends never did properly end the ceremony, so maybe that's why he was able to become possessed. On the other hand, this could just be a group of friends trying to play a prank online. It's impossible to say for sure. If it is a joke, then they managed to successfully fool thousands of people. Number 6. Bob Larson, that's the name of an exorcist who travels around the country to supposedly rid people of their evil spirits. Here is just one of the many videos showing the Reverend in action.
I don't like you. Feelings mutual.
This woman claims to have been tormented by Satan ever since her sister began praying to a demon for help after their mother passed away. She alternates between speaking in tongues and using foul language at random. The way that Bob Larson performs this exorcism is almost playful at times, but soon everything becomes much more serious.
I let the spirit come out of this. I burn the spirits of witchcraft. All of you come now.
During a different exorcism, Bob Larson encounters a demon who prefers to mock him instead of put up any form of physical resistance. He puts his hand on the possessed woman's forehead and gives her a sharp command to leave. As the exorcism wears on, the alleged demon appears to be losing its resolve.
So we left the curse. We left the curse. Straight! Mm-hmm. We left the curse.
We lit the gate.
A fire and death.
We lit the gate.
Oh.
Eventually it succumbs and leaves the woman's body. The renewed woman hugs the reverend while the crowd cheers on. Of course, these people could have been lying in order to get attention, or maybe they have legitimate mental disorders that make them think demons are lurking inside of them. They could even be paid actors working for Bob Larson to make him seem like a real exorcist when he is not one. On the other hand, however, they could actually be possessed. Once again, it's very hard to tell if these are true or not. Number 5. Come here, Deanna. Deanna Simpson lives in a notoriously haunted home in Hanover, Pennsylvania. She sees shadowy figures all of the time and has even recorded strange voices that seem to materialize out of thin air, like this one, for example. If you were to ever hear these ghosts tell you to come closer, don't listen. They apparently will try to possess you in a second, at least according to Deanna. But if you want to know exactly how haunted this house really is, then don't just take Deanna's word for it. You should ask Katie Kairos, Kai Rose, the Fox News reporter who was sent to cover the haunted home. As soon as they enter the home, one member of the film crew suddenly felt his wrist start to burn horribly.
Did you get scratched?
He was behind the camera, but Simpson knew what had happened right away.
Oh my gosh.
He'd been scratched. Simpson says it's happened to her husband, and friends many times before.
Deanna knew what had happened immediately and asked. Sure enough, there was, in fact, a fresh scratch on the inside of his arm. The cameraman later describes it as feeling like hot metal being pressed against his skin. Deanna says that this regularly happens to her, and to anyone else who enters the home. She says that this was a warning shot from the ghost, but it could be a possible possession attempt as well. She also claims to have been pushed down the stairs before. As the crew films, they see orbs coming from that area. Meanwhile, Katie gets touched and pinched by unseen figures as strange lights and noises fill the home. The reporter was definitely a believer by the time she left, along with the rest of her news team. Number 4. The laughing victim. This man was shot in the face somewhere in Brazil. A hospital worker started filming this after the gunshot victim suddenly jumped up and started laughing hysterically. Possessed or not, I've never seen someone get shot and act like this before, have you? He eventually stops laughing for a second and then starts screaming in a deep voice while walking backwards.
Pai nosso que está no céu, santificado seja o vosso nome. Venha a nós o vosso reino. Seja feita a vossa vontade. Assim na terra como no céu. E com nós...
His muscles are extremely tense and, again, I've never seen anyone move like this before in my entire life. Despite being shot in the face and losing a massive amount of blood, this man appears ready to fight anyone who gets in his way.
Você não é poderoso. Você não é poderoso. Jesus, Deus está aqui. Deus é maior do que tudo. Você não é poderoso. Deus é maior.
All attempts to reason with him are met only with growls and aggressive posturing. It looks like they are holding something in front of him to keep him from attacking, possibly a walker or some other piece of medical equipment. The doctor appears to be asking for an explanation for his behavior, and his eyes grow wide with fury as he explains to them what is wrong. Lucifer, he says. In that moment, he claims to have been possessed by the Prince of Darkness. If anyone else can translate the rest of what he says in this video, please let me know. I'd really like to understand what he's saying. If this wasn't a possession, then this man was probably high on drugs and adrenaline. Still, I've never seen someone lean that far back without falling over, especially after getting shot in the head. If he was intoxicated and injured, then he probably shouldn't be able to do that. This is another one that looks like it actually might be a legitimate possession, but again, I turn to you for an answer. Let me know in the comments below. Number 3. The televised possession. Did you know that a real exorcism was aired live on television in the early 1990s? ABC aired The Exorcism on their news show, 2020. It covered Gina, a 16-year-old girl living in Wellington, Florida, who had been in and out of psychiatric wards after seeing demons. It soon becomes clear early on that Gina's supposed demons aren't going out without a fight. First, the priests literally have to hold her down. They even insist that she will levitate if they were to let her go. This rough handling only seems to make Gina even angrier for a while. Soon she calms down just long enough to briefly talk about her situation. Apparently 10 vicious demons are taking turns controlling her every day, she says. Two of the demons she named were called Zion, Z-Y-on, and Minga, Mingar. Whether or not Zozo was one of the 10 was never revealed. Soon after mentioning them by name, her possession kicks into high gear.
God the Father, God the Son, God the Spirit.
She looks very intimidating, especially for such a young country girl, but the raw hatred in her eyes wasn't enough to deter the priests from going through with the exorcism as planned. They recite prayers while she recites prophecies of war and destruction. One priest describes simultaneously feeling the power of God mixed with the power of evil as the supernatural forces fought each other for supremacy. After a long time, the spiritual intervention was finally over. In an interview 2 months after this episode aired, Gina described herself as feeling much better now. The news story has never been picked up since, so who knows if Gina's change really lasted, or what has happened to her in the years since. So at first glance this looks like it could be a real exorcism, but then again, it could also be an instance of a news program taking advantage of a troubled girl and her family for ratings. There's no doubt that the priests believe Gina is possessed, and Gina herself is certainly not faking it, but there is just no way to tell if demons were really at work here, or if a group of overly religious people were being deceived by their own blind faith. Number 2. Pope Francis. Many regard this as the most clear-cut evidence for demonic possession of all time. Pope Francis is offering his blessings at St. Peter's Square in Rome when he places hands on a man who is very troubled indeed. Nobody in the crowd knew that the Pope was moments from performing a public exorcism, not even Francis himself. The person in the wheelchair is a 47-year-old Mexican father of two named Angel. Angel says that he has been possessed by demons as far back as 1999. So far, 10 exorcists have been unable to rid him of his demons, though they all have tried no less than 30 times. When Pope Francis lays hands on him, this is the end result. Watch closely and you'll see Angel's face twist and contort in pain, almost as if the demon is boiling under his skin. The longer the Pope lays his hands on him for, the more uncomfortable Angel becomes, and when the Pope releases him, Angel instantly slumps over and becomes tranquil. Is this an actual demonic force leaving his body, or merely the power of suggestion at play? Whatever transpired between the two of them apparently wasn't enough to end all of Angel's problems. The poor man claims he is still haunted by evil spirits. Some say that this video serves as evidence that demons and religion are not real, and that Angel is crazy instead of possessed. Others, however, insist that this is proof of how just powerful and dangerous the spirit world can be. If this a real possession, then one thing is for sure, Angel is most likely stuck with his demons for good. After all, if the Pope himself can't get rid of them for you, is there anyone left who can? Before we get to number 1, I'd really appreciate it if you followed me and feel free to send me a DM if you have a questions or suggestions. If you'd like to see more of these videos in the future, then hit that subscribe button because I upload a new video every day. Number 1. The Chosen One. As this exorcism footage goes to show, Christians are not the only ones plagued by spiritual possessions. Here you see a supposedly possessed woman trembling under the power of group prayer, and it all begins with a single concerned-looking rabbi kneeling before her. The rabbi observes her for a bit, then he stands up and says something to the crowd. Under his orders, they surround the possessed woman and begin to chant as one. It all starts out quietly, but soon it grows louder and louder as the woman convulses before them, thrashing wildly.
Oh,
As the camera pans out, you can see that many rabbis have gathered here to perform this exorcism. The fact that they have so many religious leaders present indicates that whatever is inside of her must be very powerful. The religious chanting intensifies as the woman starts to cry out in pain. The rabbis continue to vigorously shake their fists at her while shouting for her demons to leave her body at once. At this point, the group exorcism appears to be working. They pause often to see if the demon has completely left her. When they see that it hasn't, they resume the shouting once more. The woman is held down and appears to still be going completely delirious. This video cuts out abruptly, so we don't know if the exorcism was successful or not, but by the end we can see that some members of the crowd are smiling in relief. Thanks for checking out this video. Be sure to subscribe because I upload a new video every day. Or if you're still not convinced, here are some of my other videos that I think you'd like. Enjoy.